Good morning, students. So this is a continuation of value education. So one of the values that you are discussing next is our common property resources. So what are common property resources? Common property resources are those resources which are resources or services which are provided by the nature. For example, the water that the nature recycles through the water cycle, the air we breathe, the forest, the grasslands which maintain our climate and soil are all common property resources. So it is not, these are not the individual resources. These are commonly owned, and this has to be maintained through a common, they have to be maintained through a common purpose. With a common purpose, with a common intention, we have to maintain those common property resources. Next is our ecological degradation. There is something more to discuss in common property resources. So this common property resources, actually I want to give you one example. See, during the British time, before the British time, actually before the British time, this forest resources or this community forest was owned by the local people. The local tribal people, they owned this, they owned or they used this community forest resources. So they were totally aware that on this forest only their livelihood is dependent, and they can survive by preserving the forest. So as they are totally dependent on the forest, they have to preserve the forest at the same time in order to survive. So the tribal people knew that. But during the British time, the rights of the forest was taken away from this tribal people, and it was totally undertaken by the government. Community forests were totally undertaken by the government. So what happened after that? These local tribal people who were earlier used to conserve the forest by their traditional practices, they now used to exploit the resources, because now they had no right over the forest. They cannot take the resources from the forest. So they started exploiting the resources. So they had some traditional management practices which cannot be brought back. So after this, the government thought that as the tribal people are now exploiting the resources, so what we can do, if we can just engage them in the conservation process of the forest. See, anything, people will not do anything without benefit. So if people find some benefit in doing a work, then obviously they will do it. So this government, this British government, they thought that one of the way to engage this tribal people for the conservation of forest and to stop the exploitation of forest, it can be to form a joint collaboration between the forest department and the local people. As I've already told you, in forest resources, in natural resources chapter, we have learned about JFM. That is joint forest management. So what is JFM? JFM is a collaboration between the forest department or the government and the local people. So this, according to this, the government will form a committee, and the local people will be a part of the committee. This committee will work for the conservation of the forest. And also the local people will take the resources, use the forest resources for their own benefit. So this is about your common property resources. Next is our ecological degradation. You see, in many situations, valuable ecological assets are turned into serious environmental problem. So valuable ecological resources that we have, the natural ecosystem, then we have this forest, grassland, aquatic ecosystems. So these aquatic ecosystems, all these natural ecosystems are ultimately turning into a wasteland, or they are turning unproductive because of ecological degradation. So why this has happened? This has happened because we have taken the meaning of development as only economic development. We have derived the meaning of development as economic development only. There is no other meaning of development than this for us. So as we are developing economically, we are degrading the forest resources or the water resources. Then we use the forest resources for fuelwood, for fodder, to meet the demand of the rural people, the rich people, to meet the demand of the urbanized people, to meet the demand of the industries. And these are responsible for ecological damage. I can also say that changes in land use, for example, if there is a natural ecosystem, for example, if there is a forest. So if, forest provide us with many valuable services, and we have seen them in natural resources chapter, forest provide us with many valuable services. But when we are changing the land pattern of this natural ecosystem, for example, if you turn the forest into monoculture means, forest have many types of trees which are used for many purposes. But if you cut down the forest and use the forest particularly for the production of one or two crops, for example, tea or coffee or any other crop, so that is monoculture. So this monoculture, or turning that is natural ecosystem into agricultural field, it has to carry an ecological price. Ecological price means, so the land that you are using for doing agriculture, you could have got many more benefit from the forest than you are getting from the agricultural practices. So you have to pay ecological price for that. Next, again, I can say that wetland, for example, they act as a sponge and they help in reducing the effect of flood or minimizing the effect of flood. It is the intermediate between the terrestrial and aquatic ecosystem. So some part of it is water and some part is land. So this wetland also, it helps in reducing the, minimizing the effect of flood. But now what you are doing, we are degrading those wetland and using the wetland for building homes or building factories, whatever. So this also has got some ecological price. See, this wetland was earlier used for controlling the flood. They were the natural flood control system because they used to absorb the excess river water during flood. They used to absorb the excess river water during flood. But now we are capturing all the wetland for building industries or building homes, and now flood, because of the urbanization, flood is happening every year. So there is no particular pattern flood. Flood happens very frequently nowadays. It is because of this ecological degradation. So in case of forest also, as I've already said, a natural forest will provide you much more benefit. We obtain many things from the forest, starting from medicines, starting from And starting from this climate control, forest also controls the climate, they recharge your groundwater. So if you compare the economic benefit obtained from a natural forest, you will see that it is much more than a artificial ecosystem. If you cut down the forest and use the tree of the forest for any purpose, for building furniture or building homes, whatever it be, so natural ecosystem will always give you much more benefit in economic terms than that of the product obtained from degrading the natural ecosystem. Next, we will go to social justice. So you see, as we have already discussed this, that in the equitable distribution of resources, there is no equal distribution of resources in the world. So there is an urgent need of a sustainable management that will allow the equal distribution of resources. So the rich people, they are using more economic resources, energy resources per capita than the less advantaged people. So there is always a gap between the developing world and the developed world. So as the number of people, as there is no equal distribution of resources, and this poor people, they get very much less amount of resources per capita than the rich people. So these poor people, they also do not have the right to fight for, they do not have the right for right to fight for their they do not have the proper amount of resources to fight for their right. They do not have the money to fight for their right. So as a result, what is happening in developing countries, as the developing countries have more amount of poor people, so this criminal rate or this terrorism, that all these things are increasing in developing countries. So because of that, the developing countries will always lag behind. The developing countries will always lag behind the developed countries. So in developing countries, we will always see that some protest is always going on. People are fighting for their right. Terrorism is happening. There is robbery. There is crime rate are always increasing day by day. So if we are somehow economically advantaged people, we have the resources. So if we protect the right of these tribal people or the poor people, then we can move towards a sustainable nation. So sustainable social justice is one of the aspects, is one of the values of a sustainable nation. So if poor people are not respected, if they are lacking the best things in life, they will rebel, they will protest, and anarchy and terrorism will spread, as it is happening in India. Terrorism and anarchy, rebel, protest, all these are increasing because the poor people are not provided with enough resources. They do not have the proper right also to fight for the resources. So we, the economically advanced, we the educated people, we have to work for their right. We have to provide them social justice. There should be equitable distribution of resources. So you see, modern civilization is a homogeneous culture. It is a homogeneous culture. That means various type of culture exist in modern civilization. And in modern civilization, we generally believe that modern science has the answer to everything. So everything can happen scientifically. So more science has the answer to everything. This we believe in modern civilization. So science also believe that this tribal people or this tribal culture, they have their own way of preserving the environment. They have a deep sense of respecting and conserving the nature. So this tribal culture, over many generations, they have used the forest resources. They have developed medicines which have become effective against diseases, isn't it? They have provided unique forms of art, painting, crafts that are beautiful in their own ways. And they also have their own poetry. They have their dance form. They have their song, drama, and they are very much colorful people. But this culture, their tribal culture is generally getting lost day by day. Unfortunately, they are getting lost as we introduce a different set of modern values to them through television and other mass media. So we are trying to modernize in every aspect. We are trying to follow the Western culture. And as a result, we are losing these valuable tribal cultures. So this world will be culturally they will be degraded if they do not value the cultures of this indigenous people or the local people, if they do not use the knowledge of these people, tribal people. They have their own knowledge of preserving the water, land resources and the biodiversity. So if you do not preserve or value their knowledge, preserve their culture, value their knowledge, they will soon lose the beauty within the homes that is based on the things they make from the nature. So if you do not value the culture, if you do not value the art of the pottery, if you do not value the bamboo basket which are made by the tribal people, many things are made by the tribal people. So we should value them because they are aesthetically very much soothing, they are very much pleasing. So if you just replace the bamboo basket with a plastic box, of course plastic box will be more long lasting. It is a sign of the modern civilization. But what will happen if it can have many more long term negative impact, which the bamboo basket does not have? So in order to make the world a beautiful place to live in, we should respect the diverse human culture. Thank you.